Welcome to Trainlife and Europe, Engineer. As you near your graduation of the Engineer's exam, we commend you on your dream of starting your own railway transportation business. Before you graduate, we just need one final example of what you know, and some time behind the throttle won't hurt. After all, as an aspiring employer, it's best to be a shining example for your future employees. We've set up this short course in Germany for you to refresh your skills and show us what you've learned. Start by familiarizing yourself with the locomotive's controls. Then follow the instructions through the next few scenarios, and you'll be off on your own in no time at all. Take your time, but try not to derail the train. Management will have my head if a fresh graduate wrecks our training locomotive. Let's start off by taking a look around. Zooming in and out can give you a better view of the world, and your headlights are an important tool for seeing in the dark or in bad weather. Release your emergency brakes and we can get moving. We're going to start off with a nice, slow pace. Just remember to always increase that throttle carefully. Railways and wheels have very little friction, allowing you to coast. Now, slow down, so we can try to do this in reverse. Toggle your reverser. This will allow us to increase your throttle again like before. You'll be moving in reverse this time. Your emergency brakes are a necessary step for dealing with dangerous or unforeseen circumstances on the rails. Just be careful, as using the emergency brakes will wear out your locomotive the more they're used, and a worn-out train will have a worse time accelerating and braking. Let's drive forward again, but this time we want to stop in front of a switch. You always have the freedom to take whichever track you want. Try switching the direction and then drive through the switch. You can always use these switches in forward or reverse, provided another train is not currently occupying the switch. It's time to switch to the cab and get acquainted with the physical controls. Take your time and don't feel rushed. If things get too dark in the cab, don't be afraid to brighten things up a bit. You're ready to end the tutorial, or or you can stay and drive some more. If you decide to stay, use the escape menu to go to the next tutorial whenever you're ready. This locomotive is a bit busted, but still drivable. We're going to have to carefully get it to a service centre and get it fixed up, as well as refuelled. On our way there, we'll cover the basics of railway rules. Take a careful look at the speed signs and signals here. These will help inform you about what speeds you can expect to be limited to, as well as what speeds to expect in future signal blocks. Inclines and declines are an important factor to think about when driving a locomotive. Increase the throttle and pick up more speed to handle inclines, but always be prepared to scale the throttle back and increase the brakes if there's a decline soon after. Remember, your locomotive is already looking a bit worse for wear. Let's use the regular brakes to slow down before these next signals, just to be safe. Take careful note of the blocking signal lights and what they signify. Blocking signals update any time a train enters or leaves a block, so keep a close eye on these while you drive. Ah, a service centre. These will be the lifeblood of our journey. We can buy new locomotives, new parts, or customise our locomotives and transportation mode here. Always make sure your locomotive is topped up with fuel and repaired to prevent catastrophic issues. Let's reverse our locomotive with the service centre's round table and head back out. There's a locomotive ahead occupying one of the blocks. That said, the other block is free. Oh, another locomotive is up ahead. Take care to avoid it. If you make a mistake, remember to use your emergency brakes. If you can avoid fines and collisions, you'll be able to do just fine, Engineer. It's now time for the core of your work. We're going to practice taking and delivering wagons of goods. European companies and cities rely on the goods produced by its various industries. Higher tier goods are worth more, but require you to produce them with lower tier resources and goods first. Let's open the station panel now. The station panel contains all of the necessary information to plan out your journeys. Take a look around. There's no time limit. This dwarf signal may be cute, but it's also a necessary signal to watch if you want to avoid a fine for being on a station without authorization. proceed to the pickup track so we can couple our wagons. After gaining station access, the station will provide you with any relevant tracks. Let's go to the pickup track.
Thank you.
Now it's time for coupling and decoupling. When coupling and decoupling, let the station know which wagons you want, using the panel on the left. This will spawn them and allow you to go wagon by wagon, coupling them to your train. Let's use this service center to turn around, just as we did before. Let's take these logs to a sawmill so they can be processed into lumber. Open your map and select the sawmill icon. You should notice a yellow GPS route being created. Great work on getting to the sawmill. Once you've obtained access to the station, navigate to the delivery track where we can decouple these wagons.
Thank you.
Finish this decoupling, and you're set. Great work. Every wagon helps grow your company, so try to be efficient to maximize your profits and progress. Cargo is one thing, but people are less forgiving and far more sensitive to bad driving. Let's learn how to transport them safely. Not all locomotives are meant for transporting cargo. Some are commuter locomotives and are only designed to transport passengers or some postage. The service centre allows us to add or remove wagons for these trains. Try doing so now. Selecting stations on the map will allow you to set up a route, and it will automatically inform those stations that you intend to take goods from them to another station. Unfortunately, we'll have to backtrack just a little bit, as the switches we need are behind us. Take note of where the marked platform is, then navigate to it slowly and carefully. Thank you. With the emergency brakes engaged, you can open the doors and begin the process. Passengers will get off as needed, and then get on as desired. Remember, this is based on the GPS route you have set up. Depending on the train or locomotive, you can switch to a rear-facing cabin or locomotive. Try doing so now, as the commuter train you're in will be much easier to drive this way. Let's get to the final station on our journey. Announce your arrival and drop off these passengers to finish this phase of your exam. You know what to do, engineer. Let's get these passengers where they need to go.
Thank you.
You didn't think that was it, did you? There's more than one locomotive in the world, and you are destined to own them all. Well, only if you can afford them, that is. Ignore me. Let's go to the service center. You're not alone with your company, unless you want to be. For now, though, let's hire a helper to perform a delivery for us while we perform our own. Your employee list gives you a quick overview of where they are and what they're doing. If there's an empty slot, you can click on it to open the hiring window. Hire any driver that suits you.
Thank you.
You'll have to supply your employees with equipment, as well as money for fuel and service. Assign a locomotive to your new driver. Now we can click on the driver to view their details or set up a task. We're going to do the latter. On the task creation map, you can see the stations that you have unlocked, which is done by visiting the stations yourself at least once. Clicking on stations will add or remove them from the route. Set up a route now between the coal mine and the power plant. There are other options you can choose in the future, such as having the employee continue doing the task even after the first delivery is complete. For now, let's confirm the task and get to the world map. Reserved contracts are an important part of strategically planning your routes. Cargo contracts that are reserved will not expire as they normally would, allowing you to reserve the best contracts for your needs. Let's drive to the coal mine and pick up the contract we reserved. Don't forget to ask for station access. And as you drive, so do your employees. Feel free to check on their progress in the company summary tab of your tablet. When your employees complete a task, an update will appear on the HUD, telling you how much money and experience they earned from their task. navigate to the track, and pick up the wagons. It's time to put everything you've learned to the test. Deliver these wagons to the steel mill.
Thank you.
Remember when I said that as you drive, so do your employees? Well, you'll have to drive above a certain speed, depending on your chosen difficulty. Feel free to turn that off, though, if it doesn't suit your playstyle. No judgments here. Both you and your employee did great work with your deliveries. It's been great to see you in action, Engineer. Good luck with your company. But I have a feeling you won't need it.